Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Jennifer Roback Morse. If this is your first visit to the Ruth Institute, welcome. We're glad you're here. I'd like to talk with you today about the toxic environment that exists on so many of our college campuses. Many students, male and female, straight and gay, are being very wounded by the toxic hookup culture that exists in so many places. Many students, male and female, straight and gay, feel pressured to participate in the hookup culture, or at least to tolerate it. But honestly, I think most people hope for something more. The basic hookup deal is this. You get to do anything you want as long as both people agree to it. Well, now, you have to admit, that's a pretty minimal standard. I mean, what it amounts to is, I agree to let you use me as long as you agree to let me use you. There's not much there. I really think, honestly, most people hope for something more. And so they tell you, use a condom, be safe, avoid pregnancy, avoid STDs. But honestly, are those the only risks you can think of associated with casual sex? I mean, what about feeling rejected? What about worrying about whether the person will call you again? What about wondering, did it mean as much to him as it meant to me? What about the weirdness you feel seeing your hookup from last night sitting in your English lit class the next day? And what about feeling lonely during the sexual act itself? Could that be why so many students anesthetize themselves with drugs and alcohol to go through with their hookups? I mean, if it was really so much fun, why would you have to drug yourself to do it? I think most people are hoping for something more. This toxic hookup culture exists because so many people in authority permit it to exist. Some professors are giving classes that amount to pornography classes. Some RAs in the dorms are giving out condoms like candy and hoping the emotional fallout will take care of itself. And some administrators are promoting things like Sex Week that are basically glorified celebrations of the use and be used lifestyle. And what about this guy? What did he say to us? Didn't he say, exploit one another as I have exploited you? No, wait a second. That's not what he said. He said, love one another as I have loved you. And what kind of love was he talking about? He was talking about complete, self-giving, no holding back kind of love. He was talking about love that is free, full, faithful, and fruitful. Isn't that the kind of love that we all want for ourselves? Don't we hope to be the kind of person who can love that way? And of course, we all want to be loved like that. But our participation in the hookup culture is actively preventing us from growing in our ability to love in that way. Honestly, I think most people hope for something more. And it's not just students of faith who feel that there must be something missing. I've noticed students from all across the faith tradition, including students with no religion at all, who have the idea that there must be something missing, that the sex life that they're experiencing on campus has just, there has to be more to it than that. And if that's you, if that sounds like you, I just want to say to you, your intuition is right. There is more to sex than what you're experiencing in the hookup culture. If you're uncomfortable with what's going on around you, you don't have to participate in it. And you don't owe anyone an explanation or an apology for withdrawing from the hookup culture that's going on around you. And if you'd like, feel free to get in touch with us through our website, and we'll do our best to put you in touch with like-minded students so you can have a peer group so that you don't feel quite so alone and isolated, because I believe you hope for something more. And if you're a parent or grandparent watching this, please, please talk with your young people. Give them an open invitation to talk to you. You might start with something like this. Say, I've heard that there's a lot of casual sex on some campuses and a lot of pressure to conform to that. What is it like for you? And then listen to what they have to say. And if you like what we have to say, by all means, I hope that you'll consider contributing $10 to the Ruth Institute. Just go to the website, ruthinstitute.org, and click on the donate page and send us a small contribution. We'll be very grateful. I'm Dr. Jennifer Roback Morse. Thank you so much for listening.